Good morning. So, continuing from where we left off yesterday, working on Snippet Pixie next. So we're working on building a expand function, and this is going to take the body of a snippet and expand all the placeholders, such as a date placeholder or a snippet placeholder for expanding the snippet in the snippet and things like that. And we want to basically mimic the kind of functionality that we have in the existing version of Snippet Pixie. So I will grab, get that, oops, wrong one. Do not want that. Is that not? Wow. Wonder why that was autocomplete in there. Okay, so the existing expand snippet in Vala, instead of go, excuse me, starts off fairly innocently, but then gets a little bit complicated once you actually go into the little sub functions, such as going through snippets and things. So let's go back to Golang, and we'll start off by making some tests, I think, to make it like red, green as we go along. Look, there's a typo there. Yes. Okay. Right then. So we are doing this in the public or to be public package. Call this place holders test. Yes, I do. Thank you very much. Okay, let's grab some basic stuff. God, we haven't got a skeleton, have we? Oh, that's a good point. We haven't got any databases stuff. Yeah, interesting, actually. Okay. We will, however, Well, we'll start with a quick test of this. Although that's going to eventually have to start pulling other snippets from the database. So we will have to at some point branch out, pulling in database records. That'd be fun. What did I do in Vala? Did I just have a massive global list or something? Or did I just call a function? I called the manager, yeah. So if the snippet manager, yeah, So that was, see, that was an array of abbreviations with bodies as the values, I think. Yeah. I don't really want to be doing global stuff like that. So we'll see what we do there. At some point, maybe in the Go side of things, we'll have to just pass in all the abbreviations that we've got. Sorry, the snippets. We'll see. Okay. When we get there, we get there. So let's do a test then. Yeah, so we'll just do expand snippet placeholder, I guess. Because we don't really want to do expand on that, yeah, just yet. Do the low level stuff. Test. Expand. Forgot what it's called. Expand snippet placeholder? That's actually a longer name than it needs to be. Expand placeholder. No, it kind of needs to say what it's doing. So, but is this on the snippet package? So I don't need to mention snippets. So it could be snippet. Well, it's internal anyway. Snippet expand placeholders. Or it could just be expand body. Yeah. Gets the body. Snippet expand body here. That makes sense. It's kind of doom. It's better, isn't it? Nope. Alright, so we are getting T as a testing dot. I better go and do some importy things then. Oh, it'd be a good idea if I made it a function. Can't forget that. Right, and then is do that. Is equals is it new D? Expect I should do that. Okay. Alright, what we're going to do then. So, very basic test. Let's do I guess we just do body. So if we have a body that is the string, Snippet Pixie. We would expect the output to be Snippet Pixie. And then when we run it, we got as the place, we've got string int and error, yeah, because we need to have the cursor offset coming back. So we're going to do actual offset is equal to expand body, passing in the body cursor offset of 0. We need a date time. Oh, we should actually have that as a consistent thing, so we always have it. Let's do it up here. Dt equals time now. Yeah, do that, it's fine. So passing the time, we've got our last thing, haven't we? Level, yeah, level 0. Okay, so and then we'll do is equal expect actual is equal So the cursor position at the end of that expand should be an offset. To the length of the returned body, because we don't have any kind of cursor placeholder in there to say, okay, at this point within the expanded thing, you want to put your cursor. So naturally when you type, it should be expanding and you should have the cursor at the end of what you've been typing. So it should always be at the end unless there's a cursor thing going on. So let's actually fail the test here then, basically. So we're going to expect the length of expect in the offset. So That should fail now. Control Shift F10, I've got to remember that. Yep, so I was expecting 13 and got 0. So was it Control Shift F10? I keep forgetting these little shortcuts. That's great. Okay. Right. Okay, same to get rid of it, that's good. Okay, well, let's go fix that. Oops. F10. Yay. Pass. Red, green. Okay. Now let's do something a little bit more useful. So we'll just put a little comment here. Oh, really can't type again this morning. Right. No placeholders. Okay. Date placeholder. That's the one that I certainly use the most. So the body is $. Date. And we expect, what format do we expect? Forgotten. Let's have a little reference because that might be one of the ones that changes. Why is that on there? I never put that on there. It should be at 3. Okay, so expand. Yeah, so percent X by default. I'm taking it from this, so okay. So that's moved. Great. glib2 glib date time format glib date time. Okay, but format looks to be there to me. Why is that? Rala.org glib-2.0 glib datetime format. Oh, it's got a dot on the end of that. It's rendered with a dot. Let's just quickly edit that because that's a useful thing to hit every now and then. Yeah. Okay. Right. So, yeah. Okay, so it's not going to give me, yeah, so it is the locale time. So I'm going to get something different to maybe someone else. So it really depends on how it's been run. So package go standard time. What's the what does string do then? Yeah, no. That's definitely not what we want. Local returns T with the location set to local time. Fine. But I want the date in a local format. So that might be somewhere else then, is it? Okay. So, is there any kind of locale stuff? I'll look in a sec. So we've got. Here they're just doing basic format stuff. So where's the constants? Okay, so these are like not what we want because we want local things, and I don't know where that is. So I guess I could. I guess I will have to go search and see what we come up with. Local date. That's not quite right, though. That's a good point, actually. If I do that, what do I get? Examples would be good here, so I can see what it's actually doing. And why have we got these different versions? I've got to go check, see what kind of status they're at. Okay. So that's the beta set of that, which is that. Right, so that's where it started. And that went to that. And that went to that. This one. It's yet another fork. Which one to use? That's March, that's July, that's not had any releases. Maybe there's an alternate. Okay, let's do a search. Golang. Local it's not where he's really asking. Blah blah blah. No, thank you. Go away. It's not location I want. It's locale. I need internationalization, really. That's not good. This is all the same thing. Okay, so what really needs to then? Golang. What do I do? 18. Okay. Right, so what these do then? Why is that not a link? Make it a link. Next slide, okay. I want date stuff. Do you need to do this kind of stuff though? I'm going away near doing internationalization yet. That's hard to say. Here we go, day and time. Okay. Hello? Where's the bit where I get some local formatted times then? Really? Okay, right, I've had enough of this. I am going to so there's no date time formats. It's just about handling the messages and translations. Yay. So that's not what I want. That's all wordy stuff. I want that. So, okay. Use an automatic return there. Not really what I want. Translate pattern int. All right. Certain times, though, so that's not going to do it for me. That's not one I want. This one. seems to be popular. Again, it's not internationalized, is it? I am really confused as to, obviously not searching right here. So let's do some breakage. And then I'll fix it. So let's do time now. Format time dot I've got these formats. I suppose it doesn't really matter which I pick actually. Because it's just going to break anyway. Let's pick layout. Take that. All right, that's just gonna break. Now I need to go. I definitely need to find because we're not doing any expanding yet, so that's what we expect. But this day is not what I want. That's really not what I want. So I need to find, now there's got to be something in standard, which is like current locale, surely. Is there really no location stuff? Runtime? There's nothing there, is there? Okay. Okay, so this might be what I need then. How do I get the current locale though? That's the thing. Okay, well, let's give it a go. So, I need to do something like that. It's this bit that is going to be interesting. Determining what that is. On the fly. Right. So what we'll do here is so I just want to wing it in here. I just want to just make sure I can get some sort of date from that thing going on. Actually, don't need to do it here for the moment. I just need to get something working in here so I know what format I'm going to get. So let's do. So what, how is that working then? Wow. So I could do like GB. Where I am. How can that be unresolved? Because I haven't actually compiled it yet. So that's all. And then I'm supposed to just do format date short. Says, right, because it hasn't resolved it, so it's not going to do. Let's go into railway package. Probably not what I want to do. But so there we go. What? What is that then? Oh, it's the other way around. Oh, okay. So I can just put in DT. Okay. Correct. Okay, but how do I get current locale to do this? Because that can't be hard-coded. I need to know what my current locale is. Yeah. There's no method for getting it, is there, in here, so Oh, I don't want to be loading them all up. Still not showing me how to get my current locale. Okay. Now I was getting it from a web request. Now can I do something similar locally? Always that's not doing any lookups, is it? And that's what I want. In the wiki. Okay, I'm kind of lost at the moment because I don't know how to get my current locale. Clean up some of this. So The only thing I can think of is, can I grab it from date in any way? Is there another place where I can get my locale? Different, that's time zone stuff. I don't want the time zone. I want the locale, so this is really not gonna help. I want to have translations of the date time into different formats. Doesn't matter where I am, that comes by default. So where can I get that? I wonder if that's in. That would be in strings, would it? To search. Go along. Get locale. Manual. Okay, the match length thing, okay. That's not gonna work, is it? That's a lot of stuff that I need to do for just getting the language. Go look out. The detect do. Hold on, what was the date on that? Recent. Owns all available language. And what's the tag? Oh, okay. Let's give that a quick go, and then I've got to go. So right, so. And in here, we will do cow detect. This is in the test stuff, so. To get that as well, just make sure I've got that. Think. Okay. I already got it, I suppose. And then how do I deal with that then? How do I grab a locale? Oh, I'm out of time as well. God, okay. Right, so to do. It's really convoluted. There must be something. I need to go find some examples because there's no way this should be so hard just to get the locale. But, yeah, we'll find out in a minute. Monday. To do. Convert. Detected. Locale. Usable by that's not a real word. By what is that called, that library? It's locales. Okay. What's it gonna suggest as not a usable? Okay. Yeah, that was way harder than it should be. There's something I'm going to have to do a little bit of research on that because there's no way that it should be so difficult just to find out the tape format for the current user. But anyway, I guess we'll find out some other time. Well, I've got to go. So thanks for watching and until next time, take care.